Mr. Morneau, good to see you.
Hi, Rosie.
So you've invested more than $17 billion over 6 years to try, I guess, to keep Canadian businesses competitive. What evidence do you have, though, that this kind of action was actually necessary?
Well, first of all, our economy is doing well. The real focus here is how do we ensure that we continue to have the kind of investments we need to create jobs? I was out listening to business leaders over the last 6 months about how we can ensure that we continue to be competitive. And this was, frankly, the number one issue that would allow businesses to invest to create jobs for the future.
So is it preventative, or is it there are businesses that were thinking about leaving Canada, or is this really a measure to counteract that?
It's much more about thinking about the future. It's recognizing that there's always a competitive environment, that we need to be able to assure Canadians that there will be jobs, great jobs, here in the future. And those only come if businesses make investments, both Canadian businesses and international businesses. That's what we're trying to achieve.
Okay, and I guess lots of people would say, well, why not just cut corporate taxes to the same rate as the Americans then? Why did you decide not to do that?
Well, corporate taxes, what they do is effectively, if someone made an investment 5 years ago, cutting corporate taxes would increase the profit from that investment. What we're really trying to do is make sure that they make the next investment. Mm-hmm. So what we've done is we've made that next investment much more attractive from a corporate standpoint, and that'll be what will create the great jobs.
You are doing this, though, by going further into deficit, so by using Canadian taxpayers' money to try and make sure these businesses stay competitive. Do deficits no longer really mean anything to the government? Do they not matter?
It absolutely matters that we have a strong fiscal position. I start with looking at that position. We have the best situation among all of our allies. We have the lowest amount of debt as a function of our economy. That's a really important starting point. And what we've done with these changes is we've still maintained that track of reducing our debt as a function of the economy over time, reducing our deficit as a function of the economy over time. This is the fiscally prudent approach, a balanced approach to moving forward, okay, and not taking any dramatic turns.
But if the economy is doing as well as you say it is, and certainly there's evidence to prove that to be true, why put yourself further into deficit? Why is that so necessary right now? It's necessary when the economy is not doing well, but why is it necessary now?
First of all, we think it's important that we always consider the competitiveness of our environment. So we need to be thinking about tomorrow. Today, it is going very well, and we want to maintain that. Second, we do have the capacity. The economy has done well enough to provide us the capacity to do this while continuing to reduce the deficit and the debt. These are things that we need to do at the same time and do it in a measured and balanced way. That's what we think we've achieved with this fall economic statement. And that's consistent with the path that we've been on really from day one that's led us to very good economic results.
Okay, Minister Morneau, we'll leave it there. Thank you for your time, sir. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.